Just weeks ago, it was the setting for the most watched Super Bowl in history. I'm so got me feeling it's there! Hartman! Jackpot! Kansas City! Today, another historic moment at Allegiant Stadium, our Super Bowl.
Well, kind of.
I flew all the way here.
14,000 Aussie League fans flocking to Vegas.
It's all about rugby, Australian rugby, to be exact.
I'm pretty stoked to be here.
We've been here a week and it's
been
pretty good. We've been promoting it.
How you doing?
I'm good.
You sound like you've had a few.
Yeah, just a few.
It's just crazy, the things that they continue to bring here to our city.
The league even managed to squeeze an NRL pitch into the tight NFL stadium. Why? To showcase the sweet, sweet game that is rugby league in a bid to hook the Yanks.
Rugby league, a sport that's known for its greatness in Australia, has come to America. What do you know about it?
I don't know anything about it.
Well, you will now, after a 12-month build-up, finally a footy explosion all over Sin City.
Viva Rugby League!
First to grace American soil, it was the Manly Sea Eagles versus South Sydney Rabbitohs.
Onside, Mitchell goes for it himself and scores!
A 40,000-strong crowd witnessing Manly dominate South 36-24. But there's no rest for the wicked. Next up, the Brisbane Broncos took on the Sydney Roosters.
The Roosters have done it! The red, white and blue of the Roosters wins in Vegas!
So, has the NRL done enough to hit the US fan jackpot? Or will the league be coming home empty-handed?
Well, former NRL player Ben Hannant made the journey to Vegas. Ben, pretty massive turnout. How have the Yanks taken to rugby league?
Oh, it's been a massive success. All week, the buzz around this game's been unbelievable. I think it was a huge success for it. The ball's even kicked off. But I sit next to a couple of the LA Ram players in the NFL. They were loving the game. Like, we want more of this over here. So it was a great move by the NRL. And I think there's a lot of other NRL teams putting up their hand for next year.
Ben, how did you go explaining it to these Americans?
With great difficulty. I tried to explain it like the NFL. You have five downs. We kick at the end of the downs. We can pass the ball, but only backwards. But the main thing they really enjoyed were the big hits. So some incredible runs tonight. Victor Ackley absolutely smashed one of the Broncos there, and all the boys were up and about. And just the collisions and the speed that the game's played at, I think it's a credit to the boys. They gave it their all.
Our past attempts of cracking the US market haven't always been great. We've got some footage here of league legend Sturlo trying to take the field in the 80s. Do you think we did a better job of it this time round?
We did a much better job. We had at least 20,000 Aussies over here. And leading up to it, the Yanks going, what is it? What's going on over here? Because the Aussies know how to party. They got behind their teams and the Americans felt the buzz as well, so they knew something big was happening, and the boys delivered tonight. So it wasn't just the game. It was the lead-up to it. The NRL did it right, and all the NRL CEOs are over here from every other club, and they're all putting their hands up and saying, I want our boys to experience the same experience.
We've heard that perhaps NFL scouts have been watching the Aussies. Are you worried that they might pinch a few of our boys and take them over to play stateside?
What do you mean, worry? It's fantastic if they do.
Not
the
for
amount
our
of money
game.
That they get in Jordan Mailata for the Eagles, $80 million deal. Imagine a Reece Walsh going over and doing something. It's just, even the chat about that is fantastic for our game. If there's players considering or scouts looking at it, it brings more attention to the great game of rugby league and just boosts the quality of players and the level the boys will go to. Because if there's more opportunity, the boys will definitely step up.
Hang on, you're saying Reece Walsh is going to go over? Is he being stolen?
No. I'm just saying, if I was him, he's a good-looking kid. He's very marketable. His footwork tonight was electric. Even though they didn't get the win tonight, he played extremely well. And if I was an NFL scout, he'd be the first bloke I'd be looking at.
Ben, we could hear a couple of sirens in the background there. The head of Vegas police actually handed his number out to the NRL players just in case they got into any trouble. Do you know if his phone's been blowing up?
Well, I'm pretty sure sports bets have odds on who will get locked up tonight. But hopefully none of the boys. The odds are going to be out the window. There's a couple of $1.07 favourites, but I'm going to make sure I take them under my wing. I'm going to look after them. Everyone's going to get home safe. It's going to be a great experience, and there's going to be no instances tonight.
So what is the after party in Vegas? What does it look like? What's the plan? You know, burger in a bed, or what are you up to?
Burger in a bed?
Is that one? That's what the audio keeps saying.
Have you seen the Hangover? Have you seen the movie Hangover 1, 2 and 3? Essentially, it's going to be like that. Wouldn't be surprised if a couple of more boys are missing a front tooth.
Ben, before we go, I mean, do you have to translate rugby league into American? How do they go with that?
Yeah, even Australia, even talking Australian, it's like we're talking Japanese to them. But honestly, they struggle to understand what we're saying. But the main thing is that they understand the NFL. If we translate the same thing with the five downs, the main thing is they really enjoyed it. They got the entertainment, even if they didn't fully understand it. But in time, if this thing can build, Australia's onto something here. And if we can take over Vegas at least once a year for the next 5 years, it's going to be a massive step forward for the NRL.
OK, Ben, thanks for your time. Great chatting.
Thank you.
Sort of need a cultural exchange program on top of it. Just a bit more language.
I didn't realize they had to squeeze the field in because the NFL, the field's smaller than it is.
Not
rugby
so
league.
Super, is it?
I know, right? Yeah. I thought it would have been bigger, but there you go.
And it's not a bowl either, it's more like a square.
Yeah. I'm amazed that the, like with Kylie at the Brit Awards, they didn't make the NRL players do shoeies. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, because that's, they're over there now. That's
I
what
think
we make
that's
Australians
actually
do.
What's happening right now.
Right now, literally. Yeah. In amongst the casinos.
This is great for the game, though, right? Like, you know, Peter Volandi's right behind this to put NRL on the stage in the US. Hopefully they don't steal our players. I think Kevin Walters would be furious if Reese was stolen away, but great for us.
Oh, yeah, the whole thing is a credit to the boys.
Credit to the boys.